asifiwe.
Amen.
Hallelujah asubuhi ya leo.
Amen.
I thank God for his wonderful morning.
Nashukuru Bwana kwa ajili ya asubuhi njema.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Hii ni siku ambayo Bwana ameifanya.
That we may rejoice and be happy in it.
Ili tuweze kufurahi na kushangilia ndani yake.
I thank him because of life.
Namshukuru Bwana kwa ajili ya uzima.
And because of salvation.
Na kwa sababu ya wokovu wake.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I welcome you in the house of the Lord.
Nawakaribisha katika nyumba ya Bwana.
There is something special today in the house of the Lord.
Kuna kitu maalum leo ndani ya nyumba ya Bwana.
You did not leave your house for nothing.
Hukutoka kwako nyumbani bure.
God brought you here for a purpose.
Bwana alikuleta na sababu.
And you shall come out here blessed.
Na utatoka hapo umebarikiwa.
And you shall come here out here healed in Jesus' name.
Na utatoka mahali hapo umepona kwa jina la Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you so much.
Asanteni sana.
May God bless you, choir. We are blessed.
Bwana ubariki na choir, tumebarikiwa.
Looking so gorgeous.
Munapendeza sana.
May God bless you.
Bwana ubariki.
Thank you so much. Asanteni sana.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory.
Thank you for coming early and praying and singing and dancing before the Lord.
Asanteni kwa kuja mapema, kwa kuimba, kucheza na kuomba katika uwepo wa Bwana.
Bringing the presence of the Lord in the house of God.
Uleta uwepo wa Bwana katika nyumba ya Bwana.
May God bless you.
Bwana wabariki.
And reward you for the service.
Na wathawabu kwa ajili ya ibada.
Amen. Thank God.
Asante.
Thank you so much.
Asante ni sana.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today, as I was preparing to come and be in the house of the Lord for the word today.
Leo nilipokuwa nikijiandaa kuja katika nyumba ya Bwana kunena neno lake.
God is doing wonderful things in our midst, and even on Wednesday I was speaking about being in the presence of the Lord or hearing the voice of God.
Bwana anatenda mambo ya ajabu katikati yetu, na hata kama vile Jumatano nilikuwa nikiongea juu ya kusikia sauti ya Bwana.
And the Lord spoke to me as I was praying and fasting.
Na Bwana kanena nami wakati nilipokuwa nikiomba siku ya Alhamisi.
That I speak about fear because in this dispensation many people are in fear.
Ya kwamba niongee juu ya uoga. Maana wakati huu wengi wako katika hali ya kuogopa.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The fear is coming upon the church, upon the brethren, upon the nations, because of many things.
Woga unakuja juu ya kanisa, juu ya inchi, juu ya dunia, juu ya wapendwa, kwa sababu ya mambo mengi.
Many families fear about tomorrow.
Jamii nyingi zinaogopa kuhusiana na kesho.
They fear about their lives.
Wanahofia maisha yao.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
They fear about the stableness of their governments.
Wanaofia juu ya hali ya serikali yao.
They fear about each and everything they are going to attract.
Wanaofia juu ya kila jambo wanalovutia.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So I'm going to read the book of Matthew chapter 6 from verse 25 before we continue.
Tasoma kitabu cha Mathayo mlango wa 6 kuanzia mstari wa 25.
And we shall see what our God is talking to us concerning our life and our future.
Tutaona kile Bwana ananena nasi kuhusiana maisha yetu na hatima yetu.
In case you have got some fear in your life,
huenda ikawa uko na hofu maishani mwako,
I just want to tell you to have faith and have hope in God.
Nataka nikwambie uwe na imani na tumaini katika Bwana.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we are going to read, the Bible says, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are you not much better than they?
Waangalieni ndege wa angani, ya kwamba hawapandi, wala hawavuni, wala hawakusanyi ghalani. Na baba yenu wa mbinguni huwalisha hao. Ninyi je, sibora kulipita hao?
Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? And why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow, they toil not, neither do they spin. And yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. And yet, wherefore, if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is cast into oven, shall you not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? Hallelujah.
Amen.
In verse 33, the Bible says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you.
Mstari wa 33 nasema, bali utafuteni kwanza ufalme wake na haki yake, na hayo yote mutazidishiwa.
Take therefore no thought for tomorrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof.
Bas, musisumbukie ya kesho, kwa kuwa kesho itajisumbukia yenyewe. Yatosha kwa siku maovu yake.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus,
Baba, katika jina kula
we
Yesu,
thank you, Lord, for this word this morning.
Tunakushukuru kwa neno hili asubuhi ya leo.
We thank you because of your love.
Asante kwa ajili ya upendo
wako.
As
I'm standing here and the interpreter, I pray that you may use me as a
vessel. Tunaposimama hapa pamoja, ututumie kama chombo.
Holy Spirit,
Roho Mtakatifu,
give us the revelation,
tupate ufunuo wa neno lako.
Open the hearts of your people,
na ufungue mioyo ya watu wako.
I want to speak this word from you, O Lord, that they may be blessed, for you are the Lord.
In
Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As I told you before that when I was preparing to come, the Spirit of God spoke to me concerning this word called fear.
Lipo pia kwanza ndipo kwa kiti ndio kuja kunena Bwana yetu wangu kwa kati ya somo hili na uongo.
We fear about tomorrow.
Tunaogopa juu ya kesho.
We fear about our life.
Tunaofia maisha yetu.
We fear about death.
Tunaofia mauti.
We fear about our children.
Tunaofia watoto wetu.
We fear about our family.
Praise the name of
the Lord.
Amen.
And therefore, when we are sitting down or when we are living, although we are Christians and we say we believe in Jesus, but this spirit of fear, the devil has planted in the hearts of human beings in this dispensation that people no longer believe in their God, no longer believe that God is present, no longer that God is able to change
their situations.
There is no hope.
Hakuna tumaini hata katika serikali.
Every time when you read the magazines or you hear the news, it is concerning fear. Fear of sickness, fear of death, fear of no job, fear of no financial growth, fear of what our children will need tomorrow, fear of the worshiper, fear of all kinds of things in this life.
Tunapokaa na kusoma magazeti, tunapotazama habari, tunaona kila mahali hofu imetanda. Tunahofia mauti, tunahofia vifo, tunahofia mambo mengi ya kimaisha.
The so-called prophets who are talking to the people are prophesying evil things which are making people to fear. Praise the name of the Lord.
Watu ambao wanajiita manabii, wanaotoa unabii juu ya watu wa Mungu, wanatabiri zaidi juu ya kuleta inayoleta hofu.
And many people are way to follow because of fear. Hallelujah.
Na watu wengi wanakimbilia dini. Ukimbilia huko kwa watu ambao hawaamini kule ukweli kwa sababu ya hofu.
People live in fear.
Watu wanaishi katika hofu.
They don't know where their hope is, where their God is.
Hawajui tumaini lao liko wapi wala Mungu wao yuko wapi.
And Jesus was speaking to his disciples when he was here in the world.
Na Yesu alikuwa anena na wanafunzi wake alipokuwa hapa duniani.
Even those days when he was there.
Hata nyakati hizo alipokuwepo.
But there was no great thought.
Ni ya kwamba msisumbukie.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Taking thought in other words is fear. Hallelujah.
Kuwa na mawazo mengi kwa njia nyingine ni uoga.
What is?
Kuwa na wasiwasi.
What will I eat?
Nitakula nini?
What will I wear?
Nitavaa nini?
There is no job.
Hakuna kazi.
What will my children do?
Je, watoto wangu watafanya nini?
How will I give back?
Je, nitazaa?
Even if I get married.
Hata kama nitaoa.
Will I get into this, come out from this problem of poverty?
Je, nitatoka katika shida ya umaskini?
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So it is just fear after fear after fear.
Kwa hiyo ni hofu baada ya hofu baada ya hofu.
Now schools are opening.
Sasa shule zinafunguliwa.
Where will I get money for school fees?
Nitapata pesa wapi za shule?
This morning I have come to bring you hope.
Asubuhi ya leo nimekuletea tumaini.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says that we should have hope in our Jesus.
Nasema tuwe na tumaini kwa Yesu wetu.
Yourself.
Lazima ujijue.
You should know that your God is able.
Ujue kwamba Mungu wako anaweza.
Even long long time ago during Abraham's time there was a time of famine in the land.
Hata nyakati za kitambo wakati wa Abraham kulikuwa wakati wa njaa.
Even there was a time there was no rain in the land.
Hata kulikuwa na wakati hakuna mvua katika nchi.
There was no food.
Hakukuwa na chakula.
People were dying.
Watu walikuwa nakufa.
And there was no water.
Na kukuwa na maji.
And Isaac went to that land of the Philistines.
Na Isaka akaenda katika nchi ya Philistines.
The place where there was no water, where they tried to sink a borehole and they could not get water, Isaac went and sank the same places and he got water. Hallelujah.
Amen. Mahali ambapo palikuwa hapana maji, hata ukichimba kisima, maji hayapatikani. Lakini Isaka akaenda huko na akapanda na kavuna.
Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Katika jina kula
Yesu. You are going to do business where people say there are no customers.
Unaenda kufanya biashara mahali watu wanasema hakuna wateja.
And you are going to get money from there.
Na utapata pesa kutoka hapo.
Because God is your source.
Kwa sababu Mungu ndio chanzo chako.
Not people around you.
Sio watu wanaokuzunguka.
The spirit of the Lord is your source.
Roho wa Bwana ndio chanzo chako.
You are going to have a lot of customers which will be, you will not even handle them.
Unaenda kuwa na wateja wengi.
And God is going to bless your life because you are a tither, because you are a child of God, because you are a child of the King. I am prophesying over your life. Do not listen to Paul's prophets. God is going to bless your life and is going to direct your steps. May you receive it in Jesus' name. Receive it in Jesus' name. Give Jesus a mighty hand clap. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Do not confess as the children of the world.
Usikiri kama watoto wa dunia.
The Bible says, Jesus told them, do not take thought of what you shall eat, what you shall wear, how your children will live, how you will pay your rent, how you will do what. In this dispensation, it is when you are going to buy the houses. Hallelujah.
Amen. Yesu akamwambia msijisumbue kwa ajili ya kesho, mtakula nini, mtavaa nini, mtakunywa nini. Wakati huu wa dispensation, wakati kama huu, ndio mtajenga manyumba yenu kwa jina la Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Your children will go to school and they will go with school fees. What? And God will provide everything for them for the glory of God.
Watoto wenu wataenda shule na utakuwa na karo ya shule yao. Na utafanya vema kwa jina la Yesu.
If the birds in the air are eating and they are not they are not plowing, what about you who is working? God will never leave you or forsake you.
Kama ndege wa angani wasiofanya kazi wanakula na wanaishi, wewe ambaye Bwana amekupenda atakutendea zaidi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is going to change your life.
Bwana atabadilisha
maisha. He is going to bless your life.
Bwana atabariki maisha.
Do not listen to those false prophets.
Usisikie manabii.
Those who are saying devil worshippers are coming to the land.
Wale ambao wanasema abudu shetani anakuja katika nchi.
No.
La.
The Bible says that when we pray, the devil is going to run away from us. So we should stand in the gap and start praying earnestly before the eyes of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If Elijah was one person and he prayed until rain came in that land,
kama Elia alikuwa ni mtu mmoja na akaomba kwa bidii mpaka mvua ikaja juu ya nchi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What about you people who are a group of people? Your prayer is availing much in the presence of the Lord. Don't look down upon yourself. You are a child of God. God loves you. Your name is written in the book of life. You are able. Don't walk like a maskini in the presence of the people of the world. Walk like a child of the King. Walk like a child of the Lord. You are a child who can shake the world. Give Jesus a mighty hand clap. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So from today, do not fear.
Usiogope.
Don't fear about the report of the doctor.
Usiogope ile report ya madaktari.
Even if they say that you shall not be healed,
hata kama wanasema utapona,
the Bible says that our God is a healer.
Bila anasema Mungu wetu ni mponyaji.
There is nothing impossible with him.
Hakuna kisichowezekana kwake.
He can heal you from each and any disease that you have.
Ana uwezo kuponya kwa kila aina ya ugonjwa.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Give Jesus a mighty hand clap.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Glory.
The book of Psalms 23. Psalms 23.
Zaburi 23.
We have been reading this book all the time. That the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
Ya kwamba Bwana ndiye mchungaji wangu, sitapungukiwa na kitu.
Yes.
Ndio.
That word.
Hilo neno.
Put it into action. When the devil is trying to tell you that you are nothing, you cannot make it, tell the devil, my Lord says he is my shepherd.
Bwana wangu anasema yeye ni
mchungaji. I shall not want.
Sitapungukiwa na kitu.
When you have a good shepherd taking the sheep to the green pastures, praise the name of the Lord.
Ukiwa na mchungaji mwema anayepeleka kondoo katika malisho.
He takes you to a place where there's a lot of grass, where there's a lot of green leaves, and they eat. Hallelujah. You are the sheep of the Lord.
Wewe ni kondoo wa Mungu.
His eyes are upon you.
Macho yake juu yako.
Each and every morning when you pray,
kila asubuhi
he is taking you to a green pasture.
Anakuelekeza
and he's telling you, go my servant, go my child, go my son, eat what you want.
Kula kile unataka.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where there is fruits,
mahali pana matunda,
there is grass,
kuna nyasi,
there are green leaves,
kuna nyasi.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He takes care of you.
Anakulinda.
And he says, he leadeth me beside the still waters.
Na anasema ananiongoza.
When he has taken you to the green place, hallelujah,
anapeleka katika malisho majani mabichi.
He knows when you are full, you will need water.
Anajua unaposhiba unahitaji maji.
And he will bring water for you.
Na atakuletea maji.
Anytime when you are thirsty,
wakati wote ambapo nani.
When the enemy has brought you to a place where you feel you are thirsty, praise the name of the Lord.
Wakati adui amekuleta mahali ambapo unahisi una kiu.
When you call upon the name of the Lord,
unapoita jina la
Bwana, he will bring the word which will quench your thirst.
Ataleta neno ambalo itaondoa kiu yako.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because the Bible said that he brought his word to heal our diseases.
Maana Biblia nasema alituma neno lake kuponya magonjwa yetu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And when you are there in the waters, you drink.
Na ukiwa hapo majino na kunywa.
The word water represent the word of God.
Neno maji inawakilisha neno la Bwana.
And the word of God is our Lord Jesus Christ.
Na neno la Bwana ni Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo.
Whenever you are in trial,
wakati ukiwa kwa majaribu,
he will come closer to you to encourage you.
Atakukaribia kukutia moyo.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He will come and encourage you and pat you on your back.
Atakuja akutie moyo na kupapase juu ya mabega yako.
And he will bring you peace in your heart.
Atakuletea amani
maishani. He will bring peace in your soul.
Ataleta amani kwa nafsi yako.
And you will feel comforted.
Na utahisi umefarijika.
That is the time you are taking that water.
Huo ndio wakati unakunywa maji.
When you are feeling you are comforted in your trial time.
Unapohisi umefarijiwa wakati wa majaribio.
And when you are taking the word of God,
na wakati unapochukua,
you feel your heart is comforted.
Unahisi moyo wako.
That is the time you are drinking water of the Holy Spirit.
Huo ndio wakati unakunywa.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I am praying that the faith of the Lord may come into your hearts.
Naomba kwamba neno la Bwana ingie moyoni mwako.
Let your heart have faith. Praise the name of the Lord.
Wacha moyo wako ulishwe kwa jina la Yesu.
Believe in the word of God.
Amini kwa neno.
Let the word of God abide in you.
Wacha neno la Bwana likae ndani.
And when he abides in you, you will abide in him.
Utakaa ndani yake.
You will be over surrounded with the power of God.
Utakuwa umezungukwa na uwezo wa Mungu.
You will be in the presence of the Lord.
Utakaa katika uwepo.
And the enemy shall not have chance near your life.
Na adui hatakuwa na nafasi maisha yako.
When Job was having trial,
wakati Ayubu alipokuwa majaribio,
the enemy went to God.
Adui akamwendea Bwana.
And he said, you have covered Job with your power and with your presence that I cannot reach him.
Umemzunguka Ayubu na uwezo wako na uwepo wako kiasi ya kwamba siwezi kumfikia.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
You know when you are prayerful.
Unajua unapokuwa.
When you are reading the word of God.
Unaposoma.
When you have covered yourself by the blood of Jesus. When you are thinking about the things of God. The devil will not have a chance over your life. He cannot penetrate you. He will find there is a block near your life. And he cannot penetrate you. The Bible says, be closer to God and the devil will flee away from you. Hallelujah.
Amen. Pia nasema mkaribie Mungu naye shetani atatoroka.
But most of the times we don't come closer to God.
Lakini wakati mwingi hatumkaribii Mungu.
We doubt.
Tunashaka.
We pray with our mouths but our hearts are far.
Tunaomba na kinywa chetu lakini mioyo yetu iko mbali.
From today onwards, may you be delivered from the spirit of doubt.
Na ukombolewe kutoka na roho.
May you be delivered from the spirit of doubt.
Ukombolewe kutoka na roho.
Be delivered from the powers of darkness.
Ukombolewe kutoka kwa
uwezo wa giza. Of disbelief in your life.
Ya kutoamini maisha
yako. Bible says in the book of Hebrews 6.
Biblia inasema
Hebrews Hebrews 11, chapter 11, verse 6.
Kumna moja sita.
That our God is a rewarder.
Ya kwamba Mungu wetu anapeana thawabu.
To them who diligently seek him.
Kwa wale wanaomtafuta kwa bidii.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
If you are a child of God,
kama wewe ni
mwanadamu, you should seek your God diligently.
Tafuta Mungu wako kwa bidii.
Seek him by prayer.
Tafute kwa maombi.
Seek him by coming to church.
Tafute kuja kanisani.
Seek him by giving your tithe and offering.
Tafute kwa kutoa sadaka.
Seek him by evangelizing.
Tafute kwa kuhubiri injili.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he will flee away from you. He will run away from you. Can you give Jesus a mighty hand clap? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
But many people, when they are in trial, when they are in any temptation, they listen to the voice of the devil.
Lakini wengi wakiwa katika majaribu, wakiwa katika dhiki na taabu, wanasikiza sauti ya ibilisi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let us read the book of Psalms 145.
Zaburi 145.
No, before we go there, verse 2 say, he leadeth me to the green pastures, and he leadeth me to the green pastures. He restoreth my soul, and he leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. He directs you to the righteous path.
Anakuelekeza katika njia za haki.
And though you walk through the valley of shadow of death,
na ijapo unapita kati ya bonde ya vuli ya mauti,
I will fear no evil.
Sitaogopa mabaya.
Because thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me.
Kwa maana we upo pamoja nami, gongo lako na fimbo yako vanifariji.
Though you pass through trial,
japo kuwa unapitia majaribu.
Though you pass through pain,
japo kuwa unapitia
uchungu. Though you pass through lack,
japo kuwa unapitia
ugonjwa. Though you pass through sickness,
japo kuwa unapitia
magonjwa. Though you pass through any accident,
japo kuwa unapitia ajali.
The Lord's hands will be with you.
Mkono wa Bwana utakuwa juu yako.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You shall fear no evil.
Hautaogopa mabaya.
Because you shall know you are not alone.
Hautajua uko peke yako.
You are not alone.
Hauko peke yako.
You are with God.
Uko na Mungu.
Receive it in Jesus' name.
Pokea kwa jina la Yesu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And he will prepare a table before your enemies.
Ataandaa meza mbele ya adui zako.
People said that you are nothing, you will never make it, you will never succeed, you will never do this.
Watu wanasema wewe ni bure, hautafaulu wala hautaweza.
But if you are a child of God who is walking in the ways of God,
lakini kama wewe ni mwana wa Mungu unatembea katika
njia za Bwana, God will make sure, hallelujah, that he will prepare a table before your enemies. He will shame the people who are saying that you are nothing.
Atawaibisha watu waliosema wewe ni bure.
Because his name is in stake here.
Maana jina lake liko hatarini mahali.
He will not allow his name to be ashamed.
Hata ruhusu jina lake liaibike.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
That's why those people who come to the Lord drunkard, he changed them and become good people.
Hii ndio sababu watu wanaokuja kwa Bwana walevi anawageuza na wanakuwa watu wema.
Those people who come to the Lord poor, he blesses them and become rich men.
Wale wanaokuja maskini anawabariki na wanakuwa matajiri.
Those who come here not married, he blesses them and they get married. Praise the name of the Lord.
Kuja hapa wakiwa wajaolewa anawabariki na wanaolewa.
Those who come here without children, he blesses them and get children.
Wale wanaokuja hapa wakiwa tasa, Bwana anawabariki na wanakupatia
watoto. He will make sure he has prepared a testimony before your enemies.
Atahakikisha ameandaa ushuhuda mbele ya maadui zako.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The people living next to you, they will testify, surely the God of so and so.
What?
So surely the God of Mr. Joram. Surely,
oh,
the
yes.
God of Mr. Manoti.
Oh,
surely
yes.
The God of Mr. Uchie.
Oh, yes.
Surely the God of Sister Lillian.
Oh, yes.
Can you give Jesus a mighty
hand
clap? Praise the name of the Lord.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
He will lift up your children.
Atainua watoto wako.
They will go from one glory to another.
Wataenda utukufu mmoja hadi mwingine.
They will shall not be abomination in your estate.
Hautakuwa aibu katika estate yenu.
He will make sure there is a testimony coming out of your life.
Atahakikisha kuna ushuhuda unatoka kwako.
Continue walking in the ways of God.
Wataona ukitembea.
Continue believing in your God.
Endelea kuamini.
Continue lifting his hands up higher.
Endelea kuinua mkono wako.
The glory of God is going to come up in your name.
Utukufu wa Bwana utakuja juu yako.
Give Jesus a mighty hand clap. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the God I serve.
Huyo ndio Mungu namtumikia.
In this time, children of God,
wakati huu wana wa Mungu,
may you stand up as an army.
Na usimame kama jeshi.
stand up as an army.
Simama kama jeshi.
Refuse the report of the devil.
Kata habari ya ibilisi.
Refuse the report of the devil and the evil one.
Kata habari ya ibilisi na yule mwovu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And stand for the report which is pure and of good report.
Na usimame katika habari iliyo safi na habari njema.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Our God shall not allow us to be destroyed.
Mungu wetu hataruhusu tuangamie.
He will protect us.
Atatulinda.
He loves you as the nini of your eye. Hallelujah.
Anakupenda kama mboni.
Can you give Jesus a mighty hand? Praise the name of the Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
He says in verse 6, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Anasema msari wa sita, hakika wema na fadhili zitanifuata siku zote za maisha yangu. Nami nitakaa nyumbani mwa Bwana milele. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the time to start doing a new business. This is the time to tell your devil, your enemies that my God is an able God. Even if my salary is small, I'm going to start another business. I'm going to start selling the mutumba. I'm going to start cooking the viazi. I'm going to do this and this and this. And my God, praise the name of the Lord, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. May you receive it in Jesus' name. Don't sit down crying. Don't sit down saying, my God is not here. Don't say, oh, hakuna kazi. Oh, hakuna pesa. There is money. Because the Bible says silver and gold is for my God. He is the creator who created gold. He is the one who created oil. He is the one who created diamond. He is the one who created silver. And the earth is his and all the things thereof. And he is able. He says he will give you wisdom. He is the one who gives us power to be glad to get wealth. May you receive power of the God. Receive power of the Holy Spirit. Receive power of our Jesus so that you may get well. Stand up, the children of God. Refuse the spirit of poverty. Refuse the spirit of crying. Refuse the spirit of saying, I am not able. You are a child of God. The spirit of limitation, away. Away in Jesus' name. You are a child of God. Stand up and believe and start walking by faith and see the hand of God in your life. Can you give Jesus a mighty hand clap? Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory.
We are tired of seeing Christians who are crying. Oh, I cannot make it. There is no money in the government. You are blaming government all the time. The government is not your God. Jesus is your God. You just ask God to give you life. Just have life. If you are well, you can do anything through Christ who strengthens you. Give Jesus a mighty hand clap. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Psalms 145.
Zaburi 135.
He's in verse 20, he says.
Mstari wa 20 anasema.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Verse 20 says. Let us start from verse 18. He says. The Lord is near unto all them that call upon him. To all that call upon him in truth, he will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. He also will fear their cry and will save them. The Lord preserveth all them that love him, but all the wicked he will destroy.
Hallelujah. Zaburi 145 kuanzia mstari wa 18 nasema, Bwana yu karibu na wote wamwitao. Wote wamwitao kwa uaminifu, atawafanyia wamchao matakwa yao, naye atakisikia kilio chao na kuwaokoa. Bwana huwahifadhi wote wampendao na wote wasio haki atawaangamiza.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He says he is near to them that fear him.
Anasema yukaribu na wote wanaomcha.
Those who call upon his name.
Wale wanaoita jina lake.
In truth.
Kwa kweli.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not just calling his name to sayote sayote by nothing, but calling his name in truth.
Sio kuita tu jina lake kila wakati ovyo ovyo. Wale wamuitao kwa uaminifu.
Not those people who are calling the name of the Lord, and when they are in the church, as they go out, they do other things. And when they are in the church, they call upon the name of the Lord. When they go out, they do other things. God knows those who call him in truth. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen. Sio wale wanaoita jina la Bwana wakiwa hekaluni, lakini wanapotoka wanafanya mambo yao. La, Bwana anawajua wale wanaomuita kwa uaminifu.
He will fulfill their desires.
Atatimiza matakwa yao.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When you are calling upon the name of the Lord in truth, you are not mixing him with other things. You don't go to wagangas. You don't go to for prostitutions after the church. God will fulfill your desires.
Unapoita jina la Bwana kwa uaminifu, ambapo hauendi kwa waganga wala kwa mambo mengine, wala kuenda katika ukahaba na mambo kama hayo, unapomwita Bwana kwa uaminifu, yeye atakutimizia matakwa yako.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He will bless your life.
Atabariki maisha yako.
And he says he will preserve you.
Na anasema atakuhifadhi.
Those who love him.
Wote wampendao.
But the wicked.
Lakini waovu.
He will destroy.
Atawaangamiza.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Check your life that you don't become a wicked person.
Tazama maisha yako usije ukageuka kuwa muovu.
Who is a wicked person?
Mtu muovu ni mtu gani?
Is that person who hears the word of God day in day out but doesn't want to do the will of God.
Ni yule anayesikia neno la Bwana kila wakati lakini hataki kutenda mapenzi yake.
He pretends.
Anajifanya.
Is big headed.
Ye ana kichwa kigumu.
His heart is not broken.
Moyo wake haujapondeka.
You can choose to lie to the church, but the Holy Spirit is the one seeing each one of us.
Unaweza chagua kukadanganya kanisa, lakini ni roho Bwana anayeona kila moyo.
If you are not careful,
kama hautajiadhari,
the last day,
siku za mwisho,
you shall be destroyed.
Utaangamizwa.
You shall be taken to the place of fire.
Utapelekwa mahali pa moto.
But the grace of our God,
lakini neema Bwana wetu
is sufficient.
Imetosha.
He is able to forgive us.
Ana uwezo kutusamehe.
He is able to restore us.
Ana uwezo kuturejesha.
He is able to call us home.
Ana uwezo kutuita nyumbani.
To let us repent and to walk with him again.
Tunapotamani kutubu na kutembea pamoja na yeye.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let us check our lives.
Tuangalie maisha yetu.
And God will bless us.
Na Bwana atatubariki.
Our God is a loving God.
Mungu wetu ni Mungu wa upendo.
Psalms 91 verse 11.
Zaburi 91 mstari wa 11.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, shandara mbusi.
Thank you Jesus.
God bless you.
91 verse 11.
91 mstari wa 11.
It says, for he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways.
Kwa kuwa atakuagizia malaika zake wakulinde katika njia zako zote.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
If you are calling upon the name of the Lord in truth,
kama utaita jina la Bwana kwa kweli,
he will make sure he sends the angels to take care of your life.
Atahakikisha anaagiza malaika wakulinde.
You are his responsibility.
Wewe ni kati ya majukumu yake.
Isaiah 43 verse 1 to 3.
Isaiah 43 mstari wa kwanza hadi wa tatu.
Yes.
Glory to God.
The Bible says, but now that says the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name, thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. Amen.
Amen. Inasema Isaiah 43, 1 hadi 3. Inasema, lakini sasa, Bwana aliyekuuluku, Yakobo, yeye aliyekuumba, Israeli, asema hivi, usiogope, maana nimekukomboa, nimekuita kwa jina lako, wewe uwangu.
Amen.
Upitapo katika maji mengi, nitakuwa pamoja nawe. Na upitapo katika mito, haita kugarikisha. Uendapo katika moto, hautateketea. Wala mwali wa moto, hautakuunguza.
Amen.
Maana mimi ni Bwana Mungu wako.
Amen.
Takatifu wa Israeli, Mwokozi wako. Nimetoa Misri kuwa ukombozi wako, na nimetoa Kushi na Seba kwa ajili yako.
Hallelujah. Give Jesus
Amen.
A mighty hand clap.
Oh, hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
In that name, Jacob, put your name. Hallelujah.
Katika jina Yakobo, weka jina lako.
Fear not.
Usiogope.
He knows that in this world where we are living, there is a lot of fear.
Anajua mahali hapa tunapoishi. Kuna hofu nyingi.
He has saved you with his precious blood.
Amekuokoa kwa damu yake ya thamani.
He has redeemed thee.
Amekukomboa.
He has called you by his name. Praise the name of the Lord.
Kwa jina lako.
Even when you are passing through the great waters,
hata unapopita kati ya maji mengi,
it shall not overflow you.
Haita kugarakisha.
May you receive it in Jesus'
Pokea
name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Even if you are passing through the rivers,
hata upite katika mito,
even if the owner of the house is telling you are going to be thrown out,
hata mwenye nyumba kuambia unatolewa,
even if they are going to tell you are going to be taken away from your job,
hata akisema unafukuzwa,
even if your children will be taken away from school,
hata kama watoto wako,
the Lord is telling you, do not fear.
Bwana anakuambia usiogope.
He will be with you.
Atakuwa pamoja na
even
wewe.
If you pass through the fire,
hata upitapo katika moto,
you shall not be burned.
Hautaungua.
May you receive it in Jesus' name.
Pokea kwa jina la Yesu.
Give Jesus a mighty hand clap.
Hallelujah.
Fear not.
Usiogope.
Be like Shadrach and Abednego. When they were in the fire, when King Nebuchadnezzar threw them, they said, live long, O king, but we shall not bow for you to your image. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
They were ready to die. But when they were thrown in the fire, Jesus, who is a consuming fire, came down in the fire. And he became fire. And instead of these people being burned, they were walking in the fire. They were walking in the fire. Today, in the name of Jesus Christ, any fire in your life, our God will turn out to be a fire. He will turn out to be fire. And he will walk with you. He shall not burn you. God will see you through. May you receive it in Jesus' name. Give Jesus a mighty hand clap. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And when Daniel was thrown in the den of lions, our God came to
Daniel.
He is the lion of Judah. And he turned his face to become like a lion. In that pit where there were lions. So lions could not eat Daniel. They were seeing another lion next to them. And as they were there with Daniel, walikuwa wanamramba tu. Wanamramba tu. Wanamramba tu. In the name of Jesus Christ, our God, who is the lion of Judah, will turn to be a lion in your life. And every lioness in the life of this world shall never consume you, shall never eat you, shall never take away your life. God will stand with you. He will deliver you. And he will make sure you have got victory. Can you give Jesus a mighty hand clap? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Glory.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Lion of Judah,
Simba wa Yuda,
has taken us all to another way.
Amen. Tupeleka katika ushindi.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Lion of Judah.
Simba wa
that
Yuda.
Is the Lord I serve.
Ah, huyo ndio Mungu tunayetumikia.
Amen.
Amen.
Give Jesus a mighty hand clap. Praise the name of the Lord. He shall take care of you. For he is the Lord, the creator of heaven and earth. The other day, I was listening to the greatest scientist in the world. Another man called somebody Kuki from Japan. He is a professor in scientists.
Kuki kutoka Japan.
Yeah.
Professor.
He was learning about God element in the universe.
Alikuwa anajifundisha juu ya uwepo wa Mungu katika dunia.
He learned and he learned and he learned.
Alijifunza na kujifunza na
there are the people who say that there is no God.
Ni wale ambao wanasema kuna Mungu.
But when he was writing his book, when he was doing his investigation and everything,
lakini
he reached a place where they found that in the universe there is a big hole, the dark hole, and in that dark hole, when you go inside that dark hole, the other side there is a bright light.
Alifanya uchunguzi na akafanya uchunguzi akapata kugundua ya kwamba katika dunia kuna mahali penye shimo jeusi na katika ilo shimo ambalo limejaa giza upande wa pili kuna nuru.
But they could not know what is happening in the other side.
Lakini wangeza kujua ni natile kwa pandole
mwini. He came out with an answer and say, surely this universe there is God element.
Na akatoka na jawabu akisema hakika katika hii dunia Mungu yupo.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The scientists who have been denying that there is no God,
wanasayansi ambao walikataa
kuna, now they are accepting that there is God element in the universe.
Sasa wanakubali ya kwamba yuko Mungu duniani.
Even if they try to build big rockets or big houses to reach God, our God will come down and confuse them. Nowhere they will go. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hata wakijaribu kujenga maroketi na vitu vingine vikubwa, wakati Mungu huenda ushuka na akawachanganya.
He will come down. Praise the name of the Lord.
Atashuka
chini. Because he is the creator of each and everything.
Maana yeye ni muumbaji wa vitu vyote.
So don't fear.
Kwa hivyo usiogope.
Don't fear what the devil worshippers are saying.
Usiogope abudu shetani anasema nini.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The book of Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 and in it, 3 and 9.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Chapter 3 verse 5.
Mithali 3 mstari wa 5.
He says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not unto thy own understanding, and in all thy ways acknowledge him and he shall direct thy paths.
Anasema mtumaini Bwana kwa moyo wako wote, wala usitegemea akili zako mwenyewe, bali katika njia zako zote kiri yeye, naye atanyosha mapito yako.
Amen.
Amen.
Trust the Lord.
Tumainie Bwana.
Don't put your trust into your own understanding.
Usitumainie akili zako mwenyewe.
Don't put your wisdom into the things.
Usiweke akili zako kwa mambo yako.
But put the Lord's the Lord's understanding.
Lakini weka ufahamu wa Bwana.
Amen.
Amen.
Chapter 27 of the book of Psalms.
Zaburi 27.
Yeah, the Bible says, the Lord is my light, my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid of?
Nasema Bwana ni nuru yangu na wokovu wangu. Ni mwogope nani? Bwana ni ngome ya uzima wangu. Ni mhofu nani?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, come upon me to eat my flesh, they stumble and fail.
Nasema watenda mabaya waliponikaribia wanile nyama yangu, watesi wangu na adui zangu walijikwaa wakaanguka.
Though an host shall encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me in this way, I'll be confident.
Mm-hmm.
One thing have I decided of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Hallelujah.
Amen. Daudi anasema, jeshi lijapo jipanga kupigana nami, moyo wangu hautaogopa. Vita vijapo nitokea, hata hapo nitamtumainia Bwana. Neno moja nimelitaka kwa Bwana, nalo ndilo nitakalo litafuta, ni ya kwamba nikae nyumbani mwa Bwana siku zote za maisha yangu, ni utazame uzuri wa Bwana na kutafakari hekaluni mwake.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I have known why David was loved by God.
Nimejua kwa nini Daudi alipendwa na Mungu.
His heart was always in the temple of the Lord.
Moyo wake ulikuwa kila wakati hekaluni mwa Bwana.
And he knew that God is his salvation.
Na alijua kwamba Mungu ni wokovu wake.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
If you know who is your savior,
ukijua nani mkombozi wako,
not your money,
sio pesa zako,
not your government,
sio serikali
yako,
not
your security,
sio security,
the Lord,
Bwana.
Even if they come against you,
hata kama watakuja,
even if the witches go to their wagangas,
hata kama wachawi watakuja wanaenda kwa waganga,
even if they go to put zile vitu vyao, mm-hmm, it will not catch you.
Haita kukamata.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Because the Lord's presence will be upon your life.
Maana uwepo wa Bwana utakuwa juu yako.
The angels be upon your life.
Malaika wako juu yako.
And one thing you should desire.
Na jambo moja utamani.
To dwell in the house of the Lord.
Ukae katika nyumba
ya Bwana. To dwell in the presence of the Lord.
Tembee katika uwepo wa
Bwana. To dwell in prayers.
Ukae katika maombi.
To dwell in the will of God.
Ukae katika mapenzi ya
Bwana. To dwell in in evangelizing, testifying.
Ukae katika kuhubiri injili.
Dwell in reading the word of God.
Ukae katika kusoma neno la Bwana.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And prophesying, and the Bible says in the book of Revelation chapter 12 verse 11 that they overcame with their testimonies and the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah.
Amen. Na Biblia inasema katika kitabu cha Ufunuo ya kwamba walimshinda shetani kwa neno la ushuhuda wao na damu ya Yesu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
If you continue prophesying about the word of God in truth,
kama utaendelea kutabiri neno la Bwana kwa kweli,
walking in the will of God,
tembee katika mapenzi ya Bwana,
the Lord will bless your life.
Bwana atabariki maisha.
The Lord will bless your family.
Bwana atabariki jamii.
The Lord will bless the work of your hand.
Bwana atabariki kazi.
The Lord will bless your children.
Bwana atabariki watoto.
He will bless your business.
Atabariki biashara.
He will bless your family level.
Atabariki jamii yako.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And another thing you desire,
na jambo lingine unatamani,
to dwell in the house of the Lord.
Ukae katika,
you come in the morning glory.
Uje morning,
you
glory.
Come in the evening service.
Uje,
you give your tithe and your
kwe
offering. And as you give,
na
God will give back to you.
Bwana atapeana kwa
the same measure which is pressed down and running over.
Na
you don't be a selfish person.
Hautakuwa mtu mchoyo.
God will bless your life.
Bwana atabariki maisha.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As a child of God,
kama mwana wa Mungu,
I am encouraging you.
Nakutia moyo.
To come out from fear.
Toke kwa woga.
Come out from fear.
Toka kwa woga.
Come out from worries.
Toka kwa woga.
Know that you are a child of God.
Jua ya kwamba wewe ni mwana wa Mungu.
And God will bless your life.
Na Bwana atabariki maisha.
Can you give Jesus a mighty hand clap?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Give Jesus a mighty hand clap.
Patie Bwana makofi.
Give Jesus a mighty hand clap.
Patie Bwana makofi.
You are a child of God.
Wewe ni mwana wa Mungu.
Amen.
Amen.
And he says in verse 5, for in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon the rock. Amen.
Amen. Anasema mradi atanistiri bandani mwake siku ya mabaya. Atanisitiri katika sitara ya hema yake na kuniinua juu ya mwamba.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
As a child of God,
kama mwana wa Mungu,
when you desire to be in the house of God, you shall be like Jesus. You shall love like Jesus. You shall be a giver. You shall not see your neighbor in hunger and you leave him like that.
Amen. Unapokaa katika nyumba ya Bwana, utakuwa kama Yesu. Hautaona mwingine akiteseka au akiwa na njaa na ukamwacha.
You shall not see your neighbor doesn't have fare to come to church and you don't show love.
Hautaona jirani yako hana nauli ya kuja kanisani na hautaonyesha upendo.
No.
La.
You shall show love to them.
Utaonyesha upendo kwao.
And God will return back to you.
Na Bwana atakurejesha.
He will bless your hand.
Atabariki mkono.
And he will bless your business.
Atabariki biashara yako.
He will promote you where you are working.
Atakuinua mahali unapofanya kazi.
And he will lift you up.
Na atakuinua juu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can you give Jesus a mighty hand clap? Praise the name of the Lord.
Oh,
so from today, do not worry. If you have been worrying of anything, you have been worrying of your children, you have been worrying of your job financially, you have been worrying of tomorrow, I am giving you a promise that the word of God is saying is around your life. He is going to take care of you. Be strong and courageous. Do not fear. Don't even fear whatever you are passing through. Don't fear whatever the enemy is telling you. Even what the doctor said about your life. Don't fear. The Lord is with you. He will bless you abundantly. And he will bring you to his success. Let us stand up now. And lift up your hand. And I want you to start talking to God. And I want you to start telling the Lord all your fears. All your fears, tell the Lord, and He's able to help you.
Hallelujah. He has come for her, His miracle in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
We pray against this young man, the sickness which is upon his life. We destroy the spirit of sickness, of headache. We bind every powers of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We cancel every kind of sickness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And we set him free. And we call upon the name of the Lord, the blood of Jesus, to touch him and to set him free and to heal him. Right now, take your healing. Take your healing. Take your healing. Now. In the name of Jesus,
the name of
be,
Jesus.
Healed.
Be healed.
Be healed.
Be healed.
Be healed.
Be healed.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
And you also lift up your hands.
You know,
and lift up your hand and come after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. Forgive me my sins. Wash me with the blood. Write my names in the book of life. And from today, make me be your son. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus,
yes, Lord.
I pray for these brethren, oh my Lord.
Yes, Father.
This morning, oh Jehovah, they have come to your altar and they have declared by faith that you are the Lord of their life. May you touch them, oh God. Write their names in the book of life.
Yes, Lord.
Let them become your children, oh
Hallelujah.
God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Tembea katika jina la Yesu. Tembea katika jina la Yesu. Walk, walk, walk in the name of Jesus Christ. Walk in the name of Jesus. Tembea katika jina la Yesu. The Spirit of God is upon you. And walk in Jesus' name. It is done in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Tembea, tembea, tembea. Pigia Yesu makofi, tembea. Pigia Yesu makofi, tembea. Tembea. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. The angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. The angels bow before him. mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. It is done in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome, children.
Praise God. Praise God, church again. My name is Victor and I have a memory verse. It's come from the book of 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 11. It says, if we died with him, we will also live with him. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, it says, who will have all men saved and come unto the knowledge of truth? Proverbs chapter 8 verse 17, it says, I love those who love me and those who seek me shall find me. Thank you.
Praise God. Praise God, church again. I have a memory verse from the book of Psalms chapter 125 verse 4. It says, God, do good to those who are, Lord, do good to those who are upright in heart. I have another one from the book of Psalms chapter 122 verse 1. It says, I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Psalms chapter 121 verse 1, it says, I lift up my eyes on the mountain. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the creator of heaven and earth. Thank you.
Praise God. Amen. Praise God again. My name is Bran and I have a memorial verse that comes from Psalms chapter 125. It says, those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which can never be shaken, never be moved. As the mountain surrounds Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people, now and forever.
Thank you so much. And now we have a song just to bless everyone as our children go back to school. Not only these ones, but even those who are going back to colleges, we pray that God will cover them, protect them, and keep them in peace. Amen.
Tunaomba uwepo wako wewe nasi, Ee Bwana wa majeshi, tusikie kama uwepo nasi. Hatutaki kutoka hapa, hatuwezi peke yetu, nasi
huko shuleni na nyumbani. Wale wanaenda boarding, Yesu aende na nyinyi. Mpaka tuonane tena. May God bless you. Amen. Thank you. We love you. Thank you, teachers of our children. May God bless you. Amen. Wapigieni makofi. Hallelujah.